young people these days, they hesitate before getting into wildlife conservation, environment related issues.
Yeah.
Because there's no money in it, in India at least. That's what people believe.
See, I'll be quite honest, it is not one of the most monetarily lucrative fields. It is not. It is, like most other social causes, it is going to be difficult in the beginning. If you, I mean, there are a few people who have managed to strike it lucky, maybe because of, you know, family backing, or because they managed to get the right spots in the bigger conservation organizations internationally. But by and large, and the money is not that great. It's not like you will starve or that you will never be able to sufficiently provide for yourself, but it is not going to be a luxurious lifestyle. But at the end of the day, I do firmly believe that if you have the passion for something, that if you really want to work towards the cause, as long as all your basic minimum needs are met with just about a little bit of savings on the side, I think that's all that matters at the end of the day. However, people need to be very practical about this as well. There are various ways of working towards conservation and working towards wildlife besides just being part of an NGO and working for it. I know a lot of people who have corporate jobs, but maybe as donors or as supporters work for NGOs. They help network, they help people get in touch with each other. I know people who, again, with very well-paying jobs, who take up traveling as a cause, and they do this on the side as well. So it really depends on the person, and they need to be very practical about the outlooks, because especially the first 5 to 6 years are going to be difficult. They are not going to be the easiest. There's a lot of fieldwork involved, there's a lot of travel involved, so you need to be very clear on the kind of role you would like to have. If you want to be a field researcher, people need to be very well mentally prepared to be in the field, to be working in jungles for months on end, to be working in quite harsh conditions, because at the end of the day, you're actually working in the jungle, you know. And I would probably be a wrong person to really advise as to yourself how to get into this field, because I personally did my master's in English literature, and I have no idea how I found my way into wildlife conservation eventually, and I think I have been by and large very lucky as well. If people have a passion for wildlife or animals, they just need to figure out how. People can be communicators, they can be filmmakers, they can be storytellers about the wildlife. There's so many ways to go about this.
Photography?
Absolutely.
Most people are into photography and they think that's how they'll conserve.
Well, we're seeing a large surge of wildlife photographers nowadays, a very, very large surge, and honestly, that's the maximum traffic also that we see in any given national park. And 80% of the wildlife photographers are normally there to photograph the tiger. There are actually very few photographers right now, serious photographers, who are using their camera for the better. Because they all want that perfect shot of the animal, the intensity in the eye, the perfect frame with the perfect background. And while that is visually very, very pleasing, and you know, sometimes some of them do auction off the photographs for a good cause, there are only a handful of photographers who are using their skill, their talent to make a difference. For instance, we have a brilliant photographer in our country called Kalyan Verma. And it's also, I think, one of the few photographers right now who lets people use maximum of his work for free. And he puts everything under Creative Commons because he believes in the right of people to not only his work, as long as you're using it for good, but he also believes in the power of the lens and the kind of difference it can have. So sure, photography is a good idea, but let's just also again look beyond the title and look at other things as well.